So you want to start coding, but you feel as though every time you start coding or learning how to code, you quickly find yourself losing motivation. If this sounds familiar, you are not alone. As someone who has been there, there are different ways to really not only figure out how to start coding, but most importantly, how to keep up with it. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you how to start coding in 2022, but also, more importantly, is how to keep up with it. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. You all are amazing. Okay, let's just dive right into it. One of the most common questions I get asked is, I want to start coding, but A, I don't know where to start, and B, how do I keep up with it? A lot of times we start something new, we are really excited, only to have that initial motivation be lost as time goes on. This is totally normal. I want to start by saying that when you are learning something new, you are so excited at first, and over time that initial excitement can wear off. It doesn't mean that the passion for it isn't still there. It means you are human, and we just need to figure out ways to continue with it, getting through the hard parts. My first tip for you is to set a goal. Why are you learning to code? Is it for a career switch? Is it to get your first job? Is it because you want to start your own company? Really have an understanding of why you want to learn to code. This is so important because it really will impact what programming language you learn first. For example, if you have a goal of making this incredible app that you want to start a business with, and you have to really step back and think, okay, I want to make an application, maybe I should learn Swift or iOS development. If you are someone who is looking for a job or a career switch, the first thing you should do is go online and see in your area job postings and what languages are they requiring. Granted, you don't need to know all the languages or all the technologies oftentimes that are on a job posting, but very quickly you will see a trend as to what programming languages or frameworks are more in demand than others. Step number two is once you have figured out what programming language you want to learn first and you have figured out your, I guess step number one was two steps to it, step A and step B, figure out your goals for coding and then also to pick a programming language. The next step is you need to dive right in, essentially. My biggest piece of advice, if you are starting with a programming language, is to read the documentation. I know this sounds boring, and oftentimes, more than not, for me anyways, I never read the documentation when I first started, and it kicked me in the butt later on, but I can't stress enough, start by reading the documentation. For example, if you are learning Python, they have some great documentation. They also have some great suggestions on tutorials you can start with. Same with, for example, React. I know they have different tutorials on their website, different kind of how-tos, but it just gives you a really great full understanding of what the language entails. It's definitely not the most exciting thing to have to start with reading documentation, but it is the most important. Once you've read the documentation, move on to starting a tutorial. This is, I would say, where a lot of people get really excited because you're actually starting to code, which is pretty exciting. But I also think the tutorial cycle is where a lot of people end up falling off. Maybe you get stuck on the tutorial, there seems to be no one to help you. It can be a very confusing and strange area to learn in when you are learning from home through a tutorial, but you don't really have any support. My biggest piece of advice is find a platform that you are learning on or a course that offers support. So for myself, what I did was I would take different Udemy courses. There is an instructor, Maximilian, I forget his last name, but I'll put it up here, who teaches incredible courses. And what I love about it too is he actually responds to questions. So if I get stuck somewhere on his tutorial, I would ask a question and with 24 hours, he would have a response. If he didn't have a response, someone from the community would have a response for me. So I think it's so important too that although there are tons of great free tutorials online, ensure that you are doing one that has support around it. And then of course, once you've built a tutorial, start branching out and building your own projects. Don't try and build the next Facebook as your first project, although it can be easy to or tempting to want to do, but start small. And when you think of something small, go even smaller because it's always bigger than you think it's going to be when it comes to projects. And that kind of brings me to how to keep up with coding. How do you know, you're learning, you're growing, but oftentimes maybe you just get in this slump where you don't want to continue or you feel like I'm never going to get it. It's never going to click. And my biggest piece of advice for you on this one is when you are feeling that way, step away from the computer. Contrary to popular belief, you know, you think this is when I should be forcing myself to learn how to code. No, if you're not feeling it, walk away. I think that applies to pretty much even in so many areas of our life. It means that we are feeling tired and burnt out and we need a break. Always listen to your body and just be kind to yourself, because just because you're stepping back doesn't mean you're not going to pursue coding or continue to learn. No, it just means that you're being human and you need a break. For myself, really another tip that helped me keep up with learning how to code is to have a plan. So a plan from literal, I'm going to start by learning HTML and CSS, to I'm going to learn JavaScript, React, then Node, Express, backend, whatever it may be. But when I had a plan and a timeline to go along with that plan, it really held me accountable. Another piece of advice that really helped me when I was learning to code is to have a tutor. And although this isn't necessarily a free resource, so I understand maybe not everyone can go about it this way, but if you are able to hire even a computer science student or a recent grad or someone in the industry to sit down with you once a week and go through a project that you are building, it will do so, it's so valuable. It will hold you accountable. You can come with specific questions and you will grow really fast or faster. That's how I found anyways. And I literally just Googled different computer science tutors in my area, hired one for, you know, it was very affordable, and we met in a coffee shop once a week. And honestly, this really transformed my learning and made me be accountable. However, if the tutor is out of a question, I would say even just by having a friend or family member that can hold you accountable, even if they aren't in tech, can go a really long way by just talking to someone about where you are at in your learnings. The most important thing though is to remember to be kind to yourself. I think a lot of us put this crazy pressure on ourselves to have it all figured out when we are learning how to code. It can be very overwhelming. There seems to be so much to learn. Once you accept that you will never learn it all, and that's okay, even to get a job, they don't expect you to know it all, it really takes off that unnecessary pressure. Thank you all for watching this video. I'm so curious to know, where are you at in your coding journey? Are you just starting? Are you further along? Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos, and give this video a thumbs up. Okay, thanks everyone.